We're still in production for Scream. I saw something about that. Okay, I'm actually gonna do this one because I never order anything. I'm not like into shopping. It's just so boring to me. But I got sent a box while I was working, like literally a few days ago. This is from American Eagle. It's humongous on me, but it's so comfortable. It is so, so comfortable. In kissing scenes, you do kiss your partner in the scene. I'm gonna get off of that because another weird thing too, like I don't know how many of you guys drink coffee. I have never ever been a coffee person in my life. It's just not something that I'm into. But since we've been filming, a lot of my castmates do drink coffee. So I know like Mikey drinks a lot of coffee, Dylan drinks a lot of coffee. I'm talking like everybody knows. So Mikey Madison is one of my cast members. Dylan Minnette is another one of my cast members. And Sonia Amar is another cast member. They're all obsessed with coffee. And ever since I've been here, like I like the taste of coffee. I just don't feel it does anything for me. But it's like a social thing now. So when on mornings where we're not working or we have some time off or, you know, like on weekends, we'll all go to like our favorite coffee shops. But it's getting to a point where I think I like it too much. And that's concerning. I still don't feel like it does anything for me, but I just love the taste, so it's not. Is that joke you never reply? I don't. I missed it. So I'm gonna try to read the comments then. Coffee is bad. Well, I mean, I think I love bitter tastes, so I like cranberry juice. I like, but pure cranberry juice. I don't like it when people put like apple juice in it or just give me straight cranberry juice. Cranberry juice, coffee. I'm trying to think of another bitter taste that I like. I can't decide. Favorite movie? I don't know. That is so hard. I shouldn't have replied because now I've got myself stuck on this. Now I have to figure that out. I wouldn't say it's my favorite movie, but it's a movie that holds extreme sentimental value to me, and it's called A Bronx Tale. It's really great, I think. And it's something that like my entire family could watch together, and we all know the movie, and we'll still sit down and watch it every time it comes on. Intergalactic Dream Team. I don't know. I don't think I would do very good in that. I don't know enough on the topic to come up with a solid answer for you. What is my favorite song at the moment? I just posted a song by Erykah Badu on my Instagram story, and I'm just obsessed with it right now. I heard it a long time ago, but I put it on a playlist recently, and it just reminded me how great it is. So I think that that's probably my favorite song at the moment. But I also like Dark Sweet Lady by George Harrison, which I also put on my story. I'm trying to think anything else. But I'm struggling, so. I do not have a Twitch account. I barely, like, I'm so terrible about being active on here that to download, like, something else primarily for live streams, I just couldn't. Someone said spare playlist. No. My music taste is all over the place right now. It's actually pretty crazy. I used to generally stick with R&B and hip-hop playlists, But more recently, I'm trying to broaden my horizons. So I listen to a lot of rock now. Indie rock, alternative, whatever it may be. I'm gonna skip this song, actually. We can skip this one, too. I play this a lot. I'm not showing feet. What else did you play besides... Oh, I don't know. More recently, a lot of people mention or I guess kind of see me from the Netflix show. It's called You. But that's a pretty common one. Listen to Luna. Is that like a new song or is it an artist? Honestly, I had a pretty good day. It was not a bad day. Thank you for asking. I hope you had a good day as well. By the way, I'm not gonna say this, so whatever's happening here is... I'll go back to the tab. I cannot dye my hair. I mean, I can. If I ever had to dye my hair for a role, then I would dye it, and at that point it doesn't matter. If I had to dye my hair for a role, 100%, without a doubt, I would dye it whatever color they wanted. Me, personally, I feel like I would look weird with any other color hair. Also, this is just me. Like, I don't know. I couldn't do that. I could not do that. I look Brazilian, you think? I'm Mexican and I'm Puerto Rican. Yeah, no, I just couldn't. I feel like I would look so weird. And there's some people who could just pull it all off. I can't talk. This is embarrassing. No, there's some people who I feel could pull off every look, and I can't. I feel like I haven't been to enough places in the world. Me personally, I guess, out of all the places that I've been now, I know for a fact that I want to live in New York at some point in time. Like maybe early 20s, I might want to go over there just because I love the energy of the city. I feel more comfortable there, and I just feel like when you're in your early 20s and you're still kind of unsure of who you are and you're figuring out where you want or how you want to lead your life, I think that's a good place to kind of discover yourself. I think. New York does hit different. Whoever said that, I agree. I don't know. It varies. It depends on what mood I'm in. I think I really like Mexican food if we want to do like a generalization. But I also like Italian. It doesn't matter. Food is great. I have not been to New Zealand, but I would love, love to go to New Zealand. I hear it's beautiful. I have a lot of friends who work, and they shoot a lot of stuff out there. But yeah, no. I want to go to New Zealand. I want to go to Australia. I've never been to that side of the world, so I think it would be cool to kind of explore that for a bit. I want to go everywhere, really. but I've never been. Oh my god. I've probably talked about this before. People are asking you for Harry Potter house. I don't know what that is. I've never seen Harry Potter. I have to be honest. Never seen Harry Potter. I've never read Harry Potter. I have no knowledge on that universe whatsoever. I mean, I think I went to, like, where did I go? I went to, like, Universal once, and I saw the Harry Potter world, or whatever. The one in LA, so I guess it's not world, but Harry Potter land. And that's, like, the closest I've ever got to the franchise. But yes, no, I love The Office so much. It's ridiculous. My favorite character is Creed Bratton. I feel like he's severely underrated. So if you watch The Office, you probably rewatch the episodes like I do myself, and I feel like everyone does. Just pay attention to what Creed is doing. Like, all the time. And then just really listen to what he's saying, because I feel like he never misses. He's so on point. So if you like The Office, please pay more attention to Creed, because he is just... I have been to Jamaica. I went to Jamaica when I was really young. Creed really is a different... Creed, man. I love Creed. I do. I don't play Among Us, but Mason Gooding was playing that yesterday? I don't know. He plays it a lot. We'll be, like, in the middle of having a conversation, like, us at the Scream podcast, we'll sit around and talk or whatever, and Mason's playing Among Us. K2, I miss you so much. So much. It's ridiculous. I've been talking to Megan. Megan's been making me drink coffee out here. No. But I hope you're well. I miss you. And even Worm. And Tasha, of course. I didn't mean to do that, my bad. I've never seen Vampire Diaries. There's so much stuff that I haven't seen, it's kind of embarrassing. I'm not seeing anything that... Scream comes out January 14th, 2022. It sounds further away than it actually is, because it sounds like it's 2 years because we're still in 2020, but I mean, we're in the last quarter, you know? But yeah, January 14th, 2022. I'm very, very excited. It's been so interesting working around that because, like, I want to tell you guys about what we're doing because I truly think that we have a good thing going here. But I don't, all I know is I'm not going to be the one to spoil anything or ruin everything or not ruin everything, but I don't want to be the one to give everything away, you know? So I'm trying to be quiet about it, but at the same time, I want to give you guys stuff. So like even today, I had to like reach out to the studio, and I was like, would it be okay if I posted this photo? So, and if they say no, they say no. But if they say yes, then I will post it. We'll see. It's stuff like that where it's like, I would rather just play it safe than sorry. Just because a big part of the Scream, well, I mean, the main part about the Scream franchise is, you know, everything is a secret. It's a twist of turn. You don't know who the killer or the killers are, or, you know, you don't, that information is not available, and that, I guess that kind of makes the films more interactive because you're actively guessing. It's a whodunit situation. But also, like, I know everyone picks up on every single little detail, and there's already some stuff that's getting out. Or there's, like, a lot of rumor and speculation that people tend to carry. So it's difficult. I've never been a part of something where I've had to be so hush-hush before. So it's nerve-wracking. I don't know. I am not the one to ask, because I don't know. I do not know. But, I mean, it would be fun, for sure. I had such, like, that was the most fun set I had ever been on, at the time. I don't know. I think Scream is giving it a run for its money, but that was just truly a great experience. So to be able to see everyone again would be fun. My favorite artist currently? Well, my favorite artist of all time, hands down, Stevie Wonder. At the moment, I don't know. It used to be Frank Ocean, but now it's, I'm like looking at my laptop as it's playing music, trying to cheat. Who's somebody that I like? Hold on, let me go to a playlist I made the other day. Because maybe there's something. I don't know, I'm really into the zombies right now. I really like them. I really like Pink Floyd right now. Yeah, I think those are probably like the two that I'm most consistent about. But I don't know what else to click. Like, I feel like a lot of these are just repeating. Picture. Favorite thing to eat, hands down. Or I guess the thing I eat the most is popcorn. I almost deleted my playlist. No, I eat an absurd amount of popcorn. Like, probably, like, 60% of what I eat is popcorn. That's probably my number one. Somebody said something about The Weeknd, but I didn't get to finish. I don't like this update because I'm seeing one comment at a time, so I can't. That's weird. I kind of miss the old. Does it come up the way it comes up for me because it's how it's the black square? Who is your favorite killer from the Scream movies? I don't know. I kind of like Stu Mocker, and I say that because I think the actor, like, he's just so funny. Like, I love that part in the first film where, you know, he gets off the phone and he's been stabbed and he's just like, my mom's gonna kill me, or my parents are gonna kill me. I don't know, I think he brought a lot of comedy to it, but he was still intimidating at the same time. Also, he was one of the originals, so obviously, it's Stu. Who's another killer? Billy's mom, and I forgot who Timothy Olyphant played, but he was another one. Who was in the who was the killer in the third one? Oh, it was Roman. And then in the fourth one, it was... Okay, I really liked... I think Emma Roberts is very talented. And I really liked the way she portrayed the Jill Roberts twist. I thought that was really well done on her part. And she definitely did everything she needed to do to fill that space. Also, just, like, the turn on Culkin and, like, that whole, like... I don't know. It was a lot. So I think Stu Mocker first, and then probably Jill Roberts. But that a big part of that is performance, I think. Not to say that all those were just definitely standouts for me. You're obsessed with Babysitter? That's so cool. I'm so glad. We had such an amazing time shooting that. That's so nice to hear. Last time you were in Houston? I don't know that I've ever been in Houston. I went somewhere in Texas once. But I think it was Dallas. I think I went to Dallas once. I'm trying to think. I think that's it. I've never been in Houston. I know that. But I think it was Dallas where I went in Texas. I know someone from Houston. Have you watched The Walking Dead? I've never seen The Walking Dead. Here's the thing, I haven't seen a lot of television. I haven't. I don't think I have. Kendrick or Cole? Kendrick. Not to say that Cole isn't amazing, but I'm more familiar with Kendrick's work, and he's just amazing. I love Kendrick. He does not miss. Any sport team? I mean, the Lakers in basketball, of course. Dodgers baseball. Football. I don't know. I've never been really attentive towards football. But, I mean, my dad's a Cowboys fan, so it's like, it's kind of that thing where, you know, your entire family just kind of has to like the Cowboys because of that. Opinion on Ariana Grande's new single? I have not heard it. Have you watched Killing Eve? You said you wanted to. No, I haven't watched it yet. Of course I miss you, Aaliyah. Of course I do. But I miss my child more. I don't know why I did that. I've been doing this really awkward thing recently where just, no matter what people say or do, I just give like thumbs up. Like, directors will come up to me on set, and they'll be like, oh, that was a great take, but, like, you know, this is, and I'll just give them, like, a, it's really bad. I should probably knock it. No, but that's the thing, somebody will ask me, like, how old are you, and I'll be like, 18. What? What is that? Yeah, someone said, oh, no, it's bad. Sorry I play with my hair so much, it gives me something to do. Favorite flavor of Gatorade? I don't know. I don't really like Gatorade. Is that weird for me to say? I do not like Gatorade. I am filming the fifth installment of the Scream franchise at the moment. Biggest pet peeve? People who aren't polite. Maybe. People who don't wear masks. Favorite energy drink? I don't drink energy drink. It feels so bad because I feel like all of these questions, I'm like, oh, I don't do that. I've never tried energy drinks because I never felt like I needed them. Like, I'm tired a lot, but I don't like it. No, I just... Gatorade is like... I mean, Gatorade's... No, Gatorade... Whoa. I don't know. I just feel dehydrated drinking Gatorade. I like water. Also, I've been drinking a lot more water recently, so now when I drink something that isn't water, it's like... Favorite color is red. But I do like a deep, like, foresty kind of olive green. Do you eat Nerd Ropes? I actually, I don't. I had a Nerd Rope for the first time on this project I shot. I was like, oh, it was such a weird... Anyway, maybe it wasn't. I had a Nerd Rope in this project that I shot in August. And that was my first time having a Nerd Rope. Wasn't that bad, but they're hard to find. Like, we had to go to, like... Or props had to go to a bunch of different stores to find them because they couldn't find these nerd ropes. But I did enjoy my nerd rope. I prefer it to just like regular nerds, I think. Did you like being on the show, You? I loved being on the show, You. I feel like I learned so much on that show. Especially it was my first time getting into the thriller genre. So I think I learned a lot. I was definitely surrounded by... incredibly talented people, and I also made some great friendships on this show, which is cool. Are you gonna dress up for Halloween? No. What day is Halloween? Let me see. I mean, I don't have plans to dress up. I mean, it's literally the 24th. It's crazy how time just flies like that. I don't care what's new in calendar. I can't talk. Oh, it's on a Saturday. I don't know. It's not like I'm gonna go out. I feel like Halloween is kind of canceled this year. Some of you guys are out of pocket in these comments. I've never seen Gilmore Girls. Actor or actress growing up? My favorite actor growing up was Denzel Washington, and my favorite actress growing up was Dakota Fanning. Because the movie Man on Fire, I don't know how many people are familiar with that one, but that was the movie that made me want to be an actress, really. I mean, I have the idea, but I watched Man on Fire and I told my mom, I was like, I want to be the Puerto Rican version of her. No, I said Halloween is canceled because of the pandemic. You know, you can't just go around, like, handing, or it's not the wisest thing to do. I guess it was never officially canceled, but in my mind, I'm like, I'm not gonna go around interacting with a ton of people, you know? Have you ever been to Paris? Yes, I went to Paris for a few days. I was shooting in Madrid sometime last year, and I got to visit Paris for a bit, and I mean, it's beautiful there. I'm so glad I did that, because I wasn't sure about it. Somebody asked me this earlier, I do not plan on dyeing my hair. What toothpaste you use? Like the Crest Brilliant White. You know, it's in the small white bottle. I'm really not picky. That's just what I have with me now. This hairspray in my hair, and it's, I'm like trying to comb through it. I'm gonna have to wash it. Do you have any phone stories? What do you mean? I love hip-hop rap. I really love Ice Cube. I like Slick Rick. I like Wu-Tang, of course. Name yourself after a city? What does that mean? How do I do that? I don't know why I did that. Now my chest is going to be alright. I I don't listen to a lot of Travis Scott. I'm gonna be completely honest. I wonder if I get rid of this if more. Happy birthday, Charlie. I think I read that right. Harry Styles. I've listened to a few of Harry Styles' stuff. I mean, I like his style. Say no. I don't know what Among Us is. I don't. Should I? Am I supposed to get on that? I mean, I guess it's a thing now, but I really don't know. Happy early birthday, Only Jenna. Do you like Beyonce? Yeah, I mean, Beyonce is obviously a powerhouse and incredible, and but yes, try it. Really? Oh my god, Among Us? I'm sus? How am I sus? What'd I do? Damn. So I messed up somewhere here and I just... Maybe it's Among Us. Maybe that's why. Somebody said, hold on. I don't recommend playing it now, it's hacked, but... I'm not gonna finish that sentence. You don't need to bring that. Here, we don't need to mention. Give him a mention. Damn! Now everyone's saying I'm sus. If only that hurt my feelings. An actor, an actress I want to work with? Paul Dano. No hesitation. Viola Davis. No hesitation. Nicole Kidman. No hesitation. Trying to think. Ethan Hawke might be cool. Jasmine Savoy Brown. Oh wait, I'm working with her right now. Trying to think of it. Those are just the first ones off the dome. Do you know who Vanessa Morgan is? She is on, or she was she on? She was the vampire show, the My Babysitter's a Vampire or something like that. That was her, right? What movie or series did you enjoy the most? I mean, I think currently, like right now, I have had a tremendous time working on Scream. It's just been really great, and I'm surrounded by the kindest, sweetest. I've never met such sweet people in my life, and they're also so hilarious and, I don't know, just very passionate people. And they're very easy to make friends with. Oh my god, someone just said something that reminded me I need to watch. I'm thinking of ending things. I still haven't seen it yet. The Charlie Kaufman. Hi, Kim. You know who is Cole Sprouse? Yeah, of course. We live with Zach and Cody. I've never watched How I Met Your Mother. I don't listen to Weeknd a lot, but I mean, I say that, but I could probably, if you played some of his songs, I could probably go through them. Swipe up from the bottom. Hold on. Holy! Oh my God! Whoever said that? Thank you so much. You just changed my life. I mean, in this moment right now. Because now I can see so many more comments. I literally was seeing one at a time. I'm such a grandma when it comes to technology. It's bad. Also, I've been on live for a while, so I'm probably just gonna try, like, as long as there's some good questions coming within these, like, next 2 minutes, then I'll stay on for a little bit. But then it depends. If it's just the same same stuff, then I might dip. Who's your favorite rapper? I think current rapper, Kendrick. Rapper in the past, probably Ice Cube. Or Wu-Tang. But I mean, that's a group. I mean, if that qualifies. Stop, no, you're so demanding. I'm sorry, it's just I don't know what to do on here. I feel like I always host the most boring live streams because I never have anything interesting to say. But then I feel bad because I'm not active, so then I try to make up with it, and then instead you guys just have to sit and watch me sit here awkwardly and reply to the same questions that I always reply to because I don't know what else to say. Would you ever go to the moon? I would love to go to space. I would love to go to space. I want to go skydiving one day. I want to do that kind of stuff. Earth tones? Can I read? Ghostface is coming for people trying to spoil Scream by. That's the thing. It's like anybody who is actively, I don't know, people might be, whatever. Anybody who's actively trying to spoil the new installment, it's so absurd to me because I feel like if you truly appreciate and value the franchise for what it is, you're not going to try to jeopardize what it's best known for, which is the element of surprise. Do you know what I mean? So I don't know, people who try to leak stuff or spoil stuff, I don't understand that mentality, but I mean, it is what it is. No, don't what? It's terrifying. Oh, you're talking about skydiving and stuff? No, I have to. I just have to see what the world looks like from there. If I could go anywhere in the world, where would I go? I always say Italy. I would love to go to Italy. Or probably I might want to go to Africa again. Scariest movie you've ever seen? The Wicker Man, Nick Cage version. That's a joke. No, scariest. Scariest one I've ever seen? I don't know. I remember when I was younger, when I was first starting to get into horror films, I saw the first Insidious, and then I swore off of horror movies again because I don't know if you've ever seen that one, but hell no. I don't know what the scariest one is. I feel like it would never be like a classic though, because when I first started getting into horror movies, it was definitely the more recent ones. So, like, the first Conjuring, I couldn't sleep for 2 weeks after. But because I've warmed up and I've grown to love the genre, when I go back and I do revisit classics or see those classics for the first time, it doesn't have that same effect because I'm ready. It was Candyman for me? I haven't seen that one yet. I can't read. Oh, I ordered glasses a few months ago before I left my city for work, and I don't even know why. Like, LA is not my city. I don't know why I said that. Whatever, I'm no longer in LA. But before I left LA, I ordered glasses because I feel like my vision has been kind of iffy, and that's what I get for reading in the dark all the time. Not sleeping, but I ordered these like prescription glasses, and I guess I didn't customize them right, or like I chose the wrong size, like I made this like random guess, and the frames on my face are huge. Like, I couldn't even bring them when I was traveling because I was like, this is just embarrassing. But I have photos that they actually look crazy. I don't know if the light is bothering me. Favorite Ice Cube movie? I don't know. I don't really watch Ice Cube in movies. Oh my god, his son looks... I mean, this is nothing new. His son looks just like him because I did see Straight Outta Compton. That was crazy. Who's my favorite hero? I don't know. TikTok. I'm not on TikTok. If you had to live somewhere for the rest of your life, where would it be? For some reason today on set, everybody was talking about Amsterdam. So I feel like that would just be like a random executive decision, but really, New York. But I want to see Amsterdam so badly that... I don't know. If I knew I couldn't travel anywhere else, then I might. I don't know. Well, that's not good. Let's not be rash, but I am wearing makeup. I'm waiting for my castmates are watching a movie downstairs right now. They're watching the second Borat, but I don't have any more makeup wipes. I use them all already. So I have to wait for somebody to come up and then I'm gonna ask them for a wipe, but I don't want to interrupt the movie. That's why I'm just kind of... Crepes, pancakes, or waffles. Choose one, keep the other two. Someone made me have a bite of a crepe once. But I guess I'm gonna say pancakes and waffles because, I mean, I had one bite of a crepe 3 years ago. Are you going to get your friends back from the Little Rascals? Stop! I can't believe you said that. I cannot believe you said that. I haven't heard someone mention that in such a long time. Listen, I knew at the time when they put me in those bangs that there was a problem. But I also was 11 and did not care. That is crazy that you said that. That was... I'm starting to get a little delirious, which I mean it's only 10:30. I'm on the East Coast. It's not. You were 11? Yeah, I was 11. Like one of the first movies I ever did, they put me in fake bangs. God, some of these comments. Favorite part about shooting the babysitter? It was so much fun. I was just surrounded by such a great, interesting group of people. We always had a good time. Plus, I love night shoots. So if you've seen the film, it all takes place at night. So just like a great month and a half, 2 months of my favorite kind of shooting with such a funny group of people. All people I got along with. It was like the coolest. It was just a really great experience and a really cool one, and it all happened really fast. So I think that was great too. It wasn't something that I was expecting or had the opportunity to get super nervous about. I don't think kissing scenes are awkward, no, because I mean everybody knows, like, when you sign on the project, you know what you're signing up for. And then also everyone's always super safe and considerate when you're shooting that kind of stuff. The dance scene seemed fun. The dance scene was so much fun, and it also, so in the babysitter, during a scene that is kind of implying something else all of the characters kind of bring. I mean, I'm, for people who have seen it, but just for people who haven't seen it, I'm painting a picture. Whatever, there's like this really fun dance number. We're all wearing crazy outfits, and it's like, it's crazy because they use so little of the dance. I have a full take of the dance, or at least just me and Judah doing the dance, on my phone somewhere. I want to put this down, but okay. There's like a full, I have like a full minute and a half clip of me and Judah doing this dance, and it's so fun. But also that was my first time, that was really early on in the shooting. And I think it was the first time I was shooting with the entire cast. Or no, we had actually done the boat stuff with Emily first, you know, or Melanie, you know, when that all goes down. But no, the dance, it was just a really great icebreaker getting to know everyone before we shot, you know, individual deaths and things like that. I don't know if that was, though, that speech was well executed, but. Favorite show that I've been in? If you're talking about specifically series, I don't know. I think I want to say You. I think I just had such an incredible time. And I learned so much. And it's always so great to go to work and be surrounded by people who make you better. Somebody said something about dreams. And I don't know. I remember most of my dreams. But the older I get, the less crazy they get. I don't know if that's a bad thing. Working with King Batch. Oh, he's so funny. He's also the kindest. He's such a kind human being. And his energy is infectious. He's a great person. I've been on here for so long. But also I'm gonna get off and then do nothing. Well, that's a lie. I have some stuff that I wanna watch and then I have to go over another script. I really have to go over that, but I mean, I have tomorrow too. But I'm gonna go over it. Jurassic Park was so much fun. I mean, I started working on Camp Cretaceous when I was 16, I think. So it's interesting, or like that's how long we've been, like that's the thing, animation takes so long, so it's like, you go and you shoot something, and then they'll ask you to come back, like, a year and a half later to, like, still be working on the same episode. It's insane. But, no, I mean, I've been a part of that process for a while. So for it to finally be out and for people to finally see, that's pretty crazy. Or, like, going, there's, like, a, like, some of my castmates were sending, like, I guess some of the toys and outfits are out in Target with our characters on it, and that's like a weird thing to see too, because it's you, but it's not you, it's an animated version, and I don't even look like my character, so it's like I don't see myself in it, but I know it's myself. It's weird. Play Among Us. I don't know how that works. I have to look into it. Like, said something about, oh my god, I can't work this like new this new live button. Question, go for it. I don't answer my DMs. What's the most embarrassing thing that has ever happened to you? Hey, something that I haven't mentioned, I don't even know why I'm saying it, but when we were on the babysitter set, I did rip my pants. I ripped my pants in the middle of a scene, and they were turning around to a piece of coverage where they could see myself. That was really, really embarrassing. That's like the most embarrassing thing I've ever done on a set. I also fell on my face, or not necessarily on my face, but I fell a lot during that movie. Like, wiped out. Again, to be fair, or I guess not again, whatever, to be fair, I was wearing heels, and they had me doing a lot of running. That's me making excuses for myself. But yeah, no, I guess I'll delve into the story of me ripping my pants, because that's new. So what happened was, again, going back to that dance sequence in Babysitter, during the scene where Cole and Phoebe kiss for the first time, we had no time to learn that dance. There was, I think we were rehearsing, like, the day before we had a shoot. And we were, like, pulled off into, like, a dark set. It was Judah, myself, and then the choreographer. And we are trying to do, there's this part in the dance where I run up to Judah and I jump into his arms and he does, like, this dip thing. And the jeans that I was wearing were very finicky, or pants, and they were really tight originally. So I ran up and I did the jump, and this is in between takes, like, we're filming another scene, but they pulled us aside because they're like, guys, we know you don't have a lot of time. I'm so bad at explaining this, but we know you guys don't have a lot of time to learn this, so you're just gonna have to do it in between takes. So whatever. I go, practice the dance, run, jump on Judah, and then I heard something, I kind of wanted to ignore it, and then as soon as he put me down, I just felt airflow, you know, down there. And I was like, that's not good. So I looked down, and like, from my knee to, like, the crotch, like, it was completely torn at the thigh. And they're like, okay, Jenna, Judah, we're ready for you. And the choreographer left, he didn't know what had happened, and I told Judah, I was like, Judah, I just ripped my pants. He's like, what do you mean? And I'm like, you look but don't look. So, like, he looked down real quick, he was like, oh, okay, got it. He was like, just tell wardrobe. But I was so paralyzed, and I've never been this scared, like, embarrassed in my life. I was so paralyzed that he was like, all right, no, come on, like, I'll go with you. So we had to go to wardrobe together, and I told wardrobe, or he told wardrobe, he was like, hey, so there's been an issue with Jenna's wardrobe. And they're like, what do you mean? I'm like, hey, guys. And I showed them, and they were like, ooh. So we had to stop production, or, you know, like, they waited for me to get my pants sewn back together for about 15 minutes. That was awful. That's also the first time I've ever ripped my pants. I'm surprised I haven't told that story, but yeah, that was pretty awful. Like, the fact that I couldn't even go up to wardrobe by myself and just, you couldn't tell, okay, somebody just commented you couldn't even look people in the face after that. Imagine the director finding out, and then you go get your pants sewn on, and then you go on to set, and the first thing the director does is make a joke about how you just ripped your pants. I did not even know that word had gotten to McGee that I had ripped my pants, but I mean, I guess because he was waiting for me to get my pants back on so we could shoot the rest of the scene, but that was pretty awful. That was... So yeah, that's probably the most embarrassing thing that has happened to me. But also, like, I'm trying to think of anything else that embarrassing that happened during that movie. When we did reshoots in March, the scene with Max, after Allison, whatever, the boulder lands on Allison and Max comes and tries to attack us with the axe, that wasn't originally a part of the script. That was something that we did on reshoots, and so it was a brand new scene, the slide and all that. That wasn't originally in it. But there's the part where after Cole kicks Max where the sun don't shine, he grabs Phoebe's hand and, like, whatever, we run off. And when we were running off, I was supposed to, like, I don't know, the way we were turning a corner, I somehow I got in front of Judah's foot. and Judah took a step and he got the back of my heel and I straight up did like a front flip in the dust. So like all this like dirt kicks up in the air and I'm like rolling on the floor and then I sit and I turn around and I see all this dust up in the air and I just see a crowd of people running at me through this dust because they were so concerned because the fall looked so bad. It did not hurt at all because I rolled. But yeah, Judah Lewis did trip me at one point. One point during the dance I fell. During the dip at the end, like I dipped and I don't know, like Judah and I slipped and I fell on my back. Trying to think. One point during a hill, I was saying they cut like out some a part of a scene. I was like walking down a hill and I turned to talk to Judah and I just slipped and I landed like that. I don't consider myself a clumsy person. I don't fall a lot. But I think a lot of people on that side thought I was. Great way to get your steps in? I mean, I guess. I was gonna show you guys something, but then I realized I probably can't because it might be considered a spoiler for Scream, so I lied. I do love Messi. Whoever commented that, I appreciate you. Because you won't be hiking? No, the thing is, I love hiking. Just not in heels. The outfit looked comfortable, but the shirts were really annoying because they got really baggy and they would stretch out. So I went through, like, multiple tank tops, so they were constantly having to readjust the black tank top over my outfit. I could not move in the leather jacket. That's why I disappeared during the second half, because I was like, I can't do any of the stunts with this, you know, whatever leather jacket, so I had to take it off. The pants were really finicky and they would get loose a lot. Also under all of my outfits I had thermals to keep myself warm because it was freezing. I was freezing at night. It was so cold and we were shooting on a lake. Like the boat scene with Max, now all of a sudden I'm just talking about Babysitter, but there's the boat scene with Max where he's on the back on like a tube and Cole and Phoebe are on a speedboat. That was shot at 3 a.m. I couldn't tell you how cold it was, but I mean, it was November time in LA in the desert, and I was wearing this thin gray t-shirt because of course at that point I had already gotten rid of my leather jacket. I was freezing. McGee was giving us notes and my hand was shaking and I was like, yeah. Thanks, McGee. The boat scene with Cole and Phoebe talking is like all ADR. One, because it was really loud on the boat. But also, I feel like my voice was probably shaking. Maybe it wasn't, I don't know. But yeah, that entire experience was really cold. And then every time we cut, we would put on, I think there's a photo of Judah and I in our warming coats. And they also gave me a robe as well. I should give it a shot. I should give what a shot. Are they still on Among Us? I do like my brother's music. Don't need to be lower before it's all over. I promise we'll figure it out. I ain't coming down. Why would I need to? So much of this world is above us, baby. The song that's playing right now is Surf by Mac Miller. It's on the Circles album. My favorite juice is cranberry juice, no question. It's the best juice. It is the best juice. Have you seen Psycho? Of course I've seen Psycho. Favorite candy? I think Sour Patch Kids. My favorite topping on pizza? Jalapenos. Do I have any double joints? I don't think so. I mean, I feel like everybody can do the finger thing with the, you know, I don't even know if that counts as like being double jointed. My sister is so double jointed though, it's crazy. My sister Aaliyah, she's weird. She makes like her finger, whatever thumb pop out, it's gross. Is a hot dog a sandwich? I feel like I've had this debate on set so many times. I feel like technically it could be. I mean, you could argue because the bun is different. Listen, it's like 11 p.m. and I'm talking about whether or not. I was talking about it so seriously too. Yeah, I'm gonna say yes. I think it qualifies. And if anybody is against that or doesn't believe that a hot dog could also be considered a sandwich, they can fight me on it. That's just... Anyway, I think I'm gonna go watch something and then I'm probably gonna go over a script that I have to go because I know I'm not gonna go to bed anytime soon. But I really just wanted to talk to you guys because, again, I'm not very active on here. I'll try to post something like tomorrow. I don't know. We'll see. Yeah, that's all. Have a great rest of your night, guys. Have a good Saturday. Have a good rest of your weekend. Much love. Take care. Stay safe. If you're of age, vote. Vote. I have no idea. I can't even tell you. I've been looking forward to voting since I was 6 years old and I had a crush on Obama. Just do it. Oh, I keep doing that recently.